1. Concepts of marketing. Introduction. Marketing, as indicated in the term, denotes a process that is continuous in nature. The market should be continuously involved in initiating, conducting and finalizing transactions and exchange. This is an unending process and would continue till production and consumption cease to exist in the world. Meaning, the term marketing can be defined analytically or operationally. The analytic way of explaining the terms to show how marketing differs from various other activities of a firm, marketing deals with identifying and meeting human and social needs. One of the shortest definitions of marketing is meeting needs profitably. Definitions. According to Kotler, marketing is the science and art of exploring, creating, and delivering value to satisfy the needs of a target market at a profit. Marketing identifies unfulfilled needs and desires. According to American Management Association, marketing is the process of planning and executing the conception, pricing, promotion and distribution of ideas, goods and services to create exchanges that satisfy individual and organizational objectives. Thus, marketing may be defined as those business functions which are most directly and primarily concerned with three activities as follows. 1. The recognition of the demand. 2. The stimulation of demand. 3. The satisfaction of demand. Marketing concepts. Marketing concept has undergone a great change over the period. The different stages of change are explained. 1. Production concept of marketing. This is the oldest concept of marketing. It emphasizes that consumers will favor those products that are available and highly affordable, and therefore management should focus on improving production and distribution activities. This holds good when I. the demand for a product exceeds the supply and E. the product cost is high. To overcome the problem of cost, production should take place in large scale to meet the demand. At the same time, price should also be addressed so that by making available large quantity, buyer who wants to buy the product would be able to buy. But there are occasions when the product is not attractive, even at low price, the buyers may not buy the product. 2. Product concept of marketing. This concept believed that the consumers will favor those products that offer the best quality, performance and features, and therefore the organization should devote its energy to making continuous product improvements. This concept implies that there is no effort required for marketing a product, as long as the product is good and its price is reasonable. This concept remained as an important guideline for the manufacturers for quite a long time. But when considering the reality, it could easily be proved that this concept is not true. A producer may feel that he should come up with a good quality product, while the consumers may look for better solution to a problem. 3. Selling concept of marketing. In this concept, the importance of sales efforts to be undertaken to make the consumers buy the products which otherwise will remain unsold. So every organization has to make substantial selling and promotional effort to push the sales of its product. Even the best product cannot have desired sales without the help of sales promotion and aggressive salesmanship. This concept points out that goods are not bought but they have to be sold through organized advertisement and sales promotion efforts. 4. Profit concept of marketing. According to profit concept of marketing, there is a necessity for the marketing function to generate profit for the organization. But it is the production activities which would determine the cost of manufacturing, and so profit generation becomes the ultimate responsibility of the marketing function. For this purpose, the marketing personnel have to identify the right product and take it to the right people at the right time at right price through the right channel and with right promotion. This would indicate the extent to which the marketing function has to ensure profit realization for a firm. This in turn will force the production function to minimize its cost of production so that marketing function can try to optimize its activities by maximizing profit at minimum cost. On its part, the production department has to protect its own interest. So nowadays, the production department would sell the product to marketing at a price befitting its cost of production and a market quantum of profit. In turn, the marketing would determine a price with which it would be able to generate profit and also meet its promotional expenses. Hence, this concept of marketing underscores the need to minimize cost at every level, so that at every level every function can earn profit. 5. Modern marketing concept. The modern marketing concept revolves around customer. It focuses on the ultimate customer and undertakes to meet his requirements in full. For this, the organization has to correctly understand the customer requirement and deliver the desired products more effectively and efficiently than the competitors. Hence, a major shift took place in emphasis from product to customer. This has led to the manufacturers accept the philosophy, manufacturer is following the old approach. Manufacturing what he can then be would be out of business in no time. The modern concept is built in recognition of consumers' sovereignty, and so it helps every organization to maximize customer satisfaction and profit. 6. Social marketing concept. This philosophy of marketing underlines the importance of marketing activities to support and ensure social well-being. Marketing should determine the needs, wants and interests of target markets and deliver the desired satisfaction effectively. Only through this marketing can keep the competitors at bay. This broadened role of marketing is prescribed for marketing is in modern days, a number of product and services hasten environmental pollution, scarcity and inflation.
The heart of your business success lies in its marketing. Why do businesses need marketing? You need marketing because, without it, your business may offer the best products or services out there, but none of your potential customers would even know. Good marketing helps customers understand why your product is better than the competition, helps you reach your target audience, boost your customer base, and ultimately boost your business in line with customer requirements. Different sectors of marketing. 1. Business sector. 2. Non-profit sector. 3. Government sector. In business, the business sector or corporate sector, sometimes popularly called simply business, is the part of the economy made up by companies, the primary sector producing raw materials, the secondary sector carrying out manufacturing, the tertiary sector providing sales and services. Non-profit marketing refers to activities and strategies that spread the message of the organization as well as solicit donations and call for volunteers. The goal of non-profit marketing is to promote the organization's ideals and causes to get the attention of potential volunteers and donors. A government market is one which includes purchases by governmental units, federal, state, and local, that procure or rent goods and services in carrying out the main functions of the government. The market environment or business environment is a marketing term and refers to factors and forces that affect a firm's ability to build and maintain successful customer relationships. External microenvironment, small forces external the company that affect its ability to serve its customers. 8. Controllable factor, or often called as marketing mix. It includes product, price, place and promotion. Product, this factor is the most important thing to marketing, because it is the rule of satisfaction customers' needs and wants. When the product satisfy customer needs and wants, the demand of the product increase. Price, the customer needs the best price with good quality. Place, where the product can sold. Promotion, give the customers the incentive to buy the product. 2 uncontrollable factors are often called as environmental factors. It includes political factors, economical factors, social factors, technological factors, competitive forces factors, regulatory forces factor. Competition. It is important for marketers to understand their competition's marketing mix. Economy. The current economy must also be taken into consideration. Regulations. Changes in current laws and regulation are also key factors for companies to keep into consideration. Technology updates. Social environment.